So this right here is a text game that I am going to trick into becoming a World War II simulator. Nothing at all could go wrong here today. I've played a lot of World War II games, mainly Hearts of Iron 4, which I've played a lot of, but today we play AI Dungeons 2, or just AI Dungeon for all I can tell. It is a text game where it can be anything, so if it can be anything, it could also be World War II, I assume. And I guess it's not all text because there's a play and login button, and that's clearly not text, but it's close enough. So let's start. None of these settings are, World War II-ish, but I guess we can just do custom setting. Okay, and we'll make up our own prompt. You are a general in the land of France. The Germans have just attacked Poland, and in exchange, France has declared war on them. You need to decide if you want to attack Germany or not. Well, yeah, let's definitely do it, yes. You decide it is time for revenge against the Germans. Wait, that doesn't make any sense. You head towards Germany with your army and soon reach the border, where you find out that they have already been preparing their defenses. Oh, they've obviously built the West Wall today, okay? You move all your armies into Belgium to prepare for the invasion of Germany. You begin fortifying Belgium and hope that they will not bomb you to rubble. And well, I wasn't really planning on invading Germany, I was more planning on defensive. But sure, if that's possible, we'll just do that. Do you guys know what we're gonna do? We are going to steal blueprints from the Germans. Yes, we are going to steal their technology and use it against them. The panzers will be ours. So let's see if we're successful. You manage to convince your team to sneak into the enemy's HQ and steal plans for their new anti-tank gun. You bring the plans back to HQ and begin producing the gun, creating large amounts of the weapon. The anti-tank gun, that sounds very useful for stopping encirclements that may come through the Ardennes. I'm going to use some of my power of foresight here to put anti-tank guns in the Ardennes. Yes, they won't do it this time. This time there'll be a wall of anti-tank guns that we stole from them in the Ardennes. Put your new weapons in the Ardennes. You know this is a very dangerous place to put them, but you hope it will be key to winning the war. I know it is because of my knowledge of history. With my anti-tank guns in the Ardennes, we can do anything. We could even invade Switzerland if we wanted to. Let's preemptively invade Switzerland. You invade the neutral country of Switzerland. Your men march into the country, taking it over completely and holding thousands of people prisoner to use as forced labor. Wait, I didn't say I wanted to do that one. You know, I just wanted to invade Switzerland. What's going on here, guys? Free the prisoners. We're You realize that you're using the prisoners as forced labor and refuse to keep them imprisoned any longer. You march your army out of Switzerland and return to the front lines to fight. Yes, we're such good guys. Let's move divisions into Italy. You move your tank divisions to the Italian border, planning to use them against your enemies when you invade them. You quickly launch an invasion of the Low Countries and take several towns before they prepare any sort of defense. Wow, that was convenient. Wait, but I guess aren't like the Low Countries like the Benelux? I don't know where this AI thinks the Italian border is. Let's see if they capitulate. You quickly invade and capture most of northern Italy, but the Italian military holds out in several towns and cities. You call a meeting with your military commanders to discuss your next move. Okay, let's say, what do you commanders think I should do? I've never been able to ask the AI in Hoi 4 what I should do, so this is new. You ask your commanders what they think should be done about Italy, and they tell you if you want to get all of the territory back that you took, you'll need to launch a second invasion of the country. You wonder if you shouldn't just focus on regaining the ground you already lost to the enemy. Your military commanders are eager to launch another invasion, however. Oh no, what do I do? What do I do? I'm so conflicted. Are you sure the invasion is a good idea? Are you sure? I didn't really get an answer there. I don't think they're gonna change their minds. Okay, I think I have to trust my generals. I'm not experienced with this game. I don't know what's going on. Prepare the second invasion of Italy. It's done. I trust my generals, unlike somebody. Decide to prepare the invasion of Italy, but not to do it right away. You spend several months strengthening your army and preparing for the invasion. You decide to invade once again. Wait, what happened? Okay, after months of preparation, the second invasion of Italy is launched. You move through the Italian countryside with ease and conquer the towns and cities that had put up any sort of resistance at all. Okay, we were successful. Our commanders were right. I listened to my generals. Now you guys can't, call me a terrible leader. I'm not even really the leader. I am just a general, after all, actually. Maybe we could coup the government in France. Well, we'll deal with the Italians and Germans first. Okay, let's move on to Rome. You decide to use your new tanks in an attempt to conquer the Eternal City. You move the tank divisions towards the city, planning to use them to go around the anti-tank guns that are most likely defending it. Okay, let's move around the anti-tank guns. You move your tanks around the anti-tank guns you know are there, but run into a few you didn't see. Send bombers to bomb Rome. We have to weaken their forces. Can I just ask a question? Can I just ask the game, who's in charge of France right now? You question who's in charge of the French army, given that it has been suffering defeats at your hands recently. The game's just trying to blame me. Okay, I'm kind of confused. We'll just deal with Rome before I try to get involved in French politics, okay? Send in more tank divisions to support the ones that were previously attacking the city, okay? Send in the infantry. Oh no, as your men move into the city, they are cut down by machine gun and powerful anti-armor weapons. Your tank attacks failed to make any headway. You bring in the heaviest artillery to bombard the city. You decide to move your forces into the city before the Germans can launch a counterattack. Good idea. Let's have a meeting with Mussolini. Okay, we need to get this guy to surrender. You meet with Mussolini in his palace where he tries to make a deal with you. In exchange for Italian support, he wants you to promise not to invade. Yeah, that's too late, my friend. That's too late. I've taken the city of Rome. If you're willing to cede Sicily to France and join us against the Germans, we will move our forces out of Italy. What does this mean, Mussolini? You're incompetent. You don't know what's going on. I've taken Rome. How dare you question me? Who does this guy think he is? Mussolini is unruffled by your threats and tells his guard to take him to his next meeting. It's no use. You know, I own this city, so I can do what I want. Let's do it. Burn Rome to the ground. That's what you get for not listening to me. And moving on to your next meeting, you make the choice to destroy the Eternal City. But not before the Catholic population is either- Okay, that one's, don't do it. No, don't do it. No, don't do it. You realize that such a move would be counterproductive to your goal of being in power. Okay, I think we didn't do it now. I'm pretty sure. You march your army back to the outskirts of Paris, and there you begin plotting your next move. How's the AI doing? Pretty good, yeah, sure. You begin planning a coup to overthrow the leader of France, who happens to be General Charles de Gaulle. Decide to contact Churchill. No, don't! Well, I think Churchill didn't like de Gaulle, so they might be okay. I think we should overthrow the current French government and replace it with a new government of our own. Let's see how this goes. You wait a few minutes before receiving a message back. Renaud replies first, agreeing with you. Yes, it would be better to be in charge, yes. Then Churchill replies. What does Churchill reply? We're obviously in an iMessage chat, but it's okay. Hey Churchill, I know you don't like de Gaulle. You should help me overthrow him. March our troops into Paris to begin the coup. Oh, I'm meeting them in Paris? It's time to take France for Britain? No, that's not what I wanted to do. I'm not like, what's going on? I didn't know this is what I was doing. Okay, let's just do it. Let's meet with Churchill in Paris. I guess we're just, Churchill's coming to do this personally, okay. You and Churchill walk down the Champs-Élysées together. I can't say I'm entirely pleased with this plan of yours. The main thing is, I don't see how it's going to help us win the war, yeah. We need to be crushing the Germans now, not toppling de Gaulle and taking over his government. Yeah, you're probably right, but please, I just really want this. Well, okay, yes, yeah, my man, Churchill. Okay, we need to find de Gaulle. You tell your driver to take you to the Opel factory, which is located in the suburbs of Paris. You get out of your car and walk into the factory. I guess he's in the Opel factory, okay. De Gaulle, I know you're here. You see a dark figure emerge from the shadows of an equipment room. It's de Gaulle. He's been hiding there the whole time. What happened to this game? Also, this video is not sponsored by Grammarly. I just happen to enjoy the automatic correction features in games like this, where I would have no clue if I'm spelling everything wrong. He gives you a devilish grin. You might be right. He disappears again, and this time he doesn't return. What? Run towards de Gaulle. We must stop him. We must take over France for ourselves. You start running in the direction of the exit. Suddenly, a bomb explodes. You feel an intense burning sensation over all your... No! No! This can't be happening! You begin screaming and feel numbness overcome your body. Your life ends that day, and on the first day of the new year, as you burn to demonetization in a tragic fire. De Gaulle, no, what? How? Well, that was kind of sad, guys. We took Rome. We put the anti-tank guns in the Ardennes. We tried to coup De Gaulle with the help of Churchill, and then De Gaulle set off an explosive, and now Churchill and whoever I was are no more. I really am kind of confused at what happened. It was pretty entertaining, though. I'm happy that the AI is this smart now. This makes me happy for the future when the robots can, you know, just take over everything. So yeah, this is pretty cool. Anyway, I guess I'll see you all next time.